Hello everyone, this is Armeena Rana Khan and I'm in London currently to promote my feature film, Yalghaar. When we started the film, we did not know. It was nearly 3 years ago. Well, I signed it 4 years ago. I think that the things and world politics, they weren't quite this bad. But with the passage of time, I think things have gotten progressively worse. And so terrorism is very much relevant, and I think it just, the film happens to position itself in such a way that it's just released at a time when it's very much a relevant issue. What with the terrorist attacks in Manchester and, you know, and recently in London, and of course not to forget Pakistan, where people continue to suffer heavy losses on a daily basis. I think that this film highlights the sacrifices that people make, and I think that it can be applied to any ethnicity, any background, because terrorism is spread all across the board. It's not something that affects one country or one ethnicity or one shade of color. You know, when it comes to human beings, it's a global problem. So I think this film is relevant for everyone, and everyone can take away something from it. It's very important to highlight the unsung heroes. These are soldiers, these are real people that the film highlights and honors their memory. But I think more importantly, it just puts the human element into perspective. It touches upon their relationships, it touches upon their lives on a microscopic level. You actually see the effects of tragedy and of terrorism, how it affects them and their family life and those that they love and those that are loved by them. So I think it's just very important to have films that highlight such heroes, because they contribute a large part. They sacrifice themselves, and I think that those sacrifices should not go unnoticed. And if we can highlight, say, the Kandil Balochis of the world, then why can't we highlight a few soldiers? It's all relative. Kandil Baloch was obviously a social media star who was executed for being, she was honor killed for being outspoken and for standing up for herself and being herself. So currently there is a biopic on her being made, but I feel that this is equally as relevant for anyone, because these are just mere soldiers, and their stories would not be told if it hadn't been for this film. They would be faceless. So I think that with this film, we're just celebrating them and their lives. And I think that more films like this should be made, where you are paying tribute to people who sacrifice their lives too for a good cause. But most Pakistani films that have been made have had either damsels in distress or as supports for the main leads. Yes, this is a testosterone-filled film, and it's mainly about the men, but the females, the female actors the characters that have been represented are very strong. You have a journalist, you have a doctor, you have my character who's educated and who's feisty and who knows what she wants. She's career orientated and she's strong. She stands up to people. So I think we're setting the right tone with the film as to how women should be represented in Pakistani films. And I think this film is very important and integral into doing that, because I think that other people will follow suit, because I think I've personally had a lot of praise for my other film, where I played a very strong Pashtun girl. Now, Pashtuns are from the northern side of Pakistan, and they're mostly not given equal opportunities as a girl from a city would, so they're even more suppressed. And how I portrayed that particular character was extremely strong, and how a Pashtun woman wouldn't be. But, you know, this is when you set the tone that, okay, this is how things should be. And I think the media is such an important tool, medium for educating people that, look, women can be soldiers, women can be journalists, they can be doctors, as you can see in the film. So it's not such an alien concept. So I think if you take that aspect of the film into regard, then it's a very important film, because I think women can now be seen in other roles other than just being that romantic heroine. I think Hassan Rana, we call him Doc, he is he's a revolutionary, and I think that he's a genius because of the way that he handles everything. I mean, he's multi-talented. He's written the script, he's directed it, he's acted in it, and he's even written the lyrics to some of the songs. So, I mean, you know, the man is just master of all trades, sort of a scenario, and I feel that people like him, who are so self-sufficient, will go a long way into contributing towards the future of Pakistani cinema. And likewise, he has an eye for spotting the right kind of talent, the right kind of people to push forward, because the last thing that we need are, you know, backward extremist people being perpetuated into the media. We don't want those kind of voices. We want strong, educated women being highlighted in that part of the world, and he's doing just that. So I think that he's pioneering in ways that we don't even know yet, because we're still such a fledgling small industry. And I think that filmmakers like him need to be encouraged, because I think he's on to something. I think special is the right word, because he's literally just taken the few handful of individuals that can actually speak on a world stage, can represent Pakistan in a positive light. As I said, he has an eye for talent. So I think working with them has been extremely rewarding for me, because I am British and I am doing the exact opposite. I'm not working here. Instead, I'm going back because I feel that I'm needed. I'm a strong voice for women out there. I'm a great advocate for women's rights and empowerment. And I feel that a woman like me, when I go back there and I represent women, I inspire something in the women there. And I get so many messages on a daily basis that we can't thank you enough for coming here and working and almost paving the way, blazing the way for us, because we wouldn't know how to handle this particular situation, so you're quite bold. And it almost fills me up with a sense of, I'm almost grateful to be in the position that I am, because I think I'm the first one of my kind to go out there and work the exact opposite. And likewise, I'm learning so much from these actors on how to adapt to that culture. Because if it wasn't for them and them speaking my language, I wouldn't be able to fit in, you know, because there are lots of barriers to me working there. Like, my first barrier was my language, which I had to work on for 2 years. So, you know, some of these people have been quite integral to my success, because they've given me the kind of support that I needed when I was out there and trying to find my wings, so. I'm very excited to announce that I've just been signed on to a British feature film. It's called The Real Target, and I'm the only girl with any sort of Pakistani links to it. So I'm playing a double agent, Canadian-British agent, and I'm both those things, in fact, and in reality too. And I'm super proud, because they're also on a journey to have people of color be represented in Hollywood. I feel there's also a whole new debate there. Not new, but it's an old debate, but it's a debate nonetheless. And there is an underrepresentation of Asian actors there also. So they're making a film, and you know, you're going to have an ensemble cast from China, from Singapore, from Malaysia to India to Pakistan to Saudi Arabia. It's an amazing cast. And you know, and I think we can do wonders with that once it hits the cinemas. So that's one to watch out for. We live in a globalized world, so why shouldn't we have globalized cinema also? Let's be inclusive of everyone. Let's not divide people. Let's not divide cinema, because cinema is a great way to unite people. We understand the language of love all over the world. So why not have one language, one cinema all across the world, where you have various stars coming in and working in one industry? Let's have those open doors and open policy, because I think that that togetherness can only open other doors, and we can have huge impact. You know, we can export culture, we can export the right kind of messages, because people are perceptive to their own stars, to their own faces. And if you include them in those films, then you suddenly you're availing those markets that would otherwise not be available to you, because you have their attention suddenly by being inclusive of their, by including their actors and stars. So I think it's a great way to expand globally. So I think it's important to do that.